Hey guys, welcome back to the workshop. Today we're going to try to make our own version of a simple experiment you may have seen before. This little device here lets you connect two soda bottles together to make a tornado tube. To make it work, you simply fill one soda bottle 2/3 full of water, attach the tornado tube device, and then screw the other soda bottle into the top of it. You can see that there are threads that hold the device onto the soda bottle, and then a small smooth hole down through the center. So to make this device work the way we want to, we're going to flip it upside down and quickly shake it in a circular motion. Watch what happens. Now, as you can see, we've got this cool water vortex forming in the upper chamber. So what happens is as the water swirls around, it's able to drain just on the edges of the hole in the connector, while the center of the hole has air flowing up through it into the bottle on the top. Because air is able to flow into the top bottle as the water drains into the lower bottle, the pressure between them stays equal and the water is able to flow smoothly. Now we see how this version works, let's try to build our own. All of the equipment that we're gonna need today is two clear 2-liter soda bottles, a 1-inch PVC coupling, and a glue gun. Now our 1-inch PVC coupling fits over our cap with just a little bit of room to spare. To secure it, I'm gonna take some hot glue and spread that all the way around the sides of this cap, which has some ridges on it to help with grip, and I'm hoping that'll also help it stick to our PVC a little bit better. To ensure we have a good grip on the PVC itself, I'm just gonna take a little bit of sandpaper and rough up the inside. Trying to apply the glue fairly quickly so that it doesn't cool down before I can then fit our coupling over the cap. And you can see that the coupling has a middle stripe going around the middle, and we want that end sort of right at the same level as the soda bottle cap. With our coupling attached to the first cap, now we'll take the glue gun, go around the edge to ensure a good connection, and then keep adding glue, covering the entire cap. That way we'll have just a small pool of hot glue, a couple of millimeters thick. As soon as we have our hot glue pool down inside our coupling, we'll take our other soda bottle with the cap attached, flip it upside down, and press the cap down into the hot glue. There was a pretty good amount of hot glue inside the coupling there, so we're gonna give that just a couple minutes to cool down. Once it has, we'll try and disconnect both bottles from their caps inside the connector. There we go. First bottle comes off pretty nicely. You can actually see that when I press the bottle down into the puddle of hot glue, some of it oozed up past the cap. That's what we want. It means there's glue surrounding the sides of the cap and should give it a really nice connection. So now we have our two caps inside our PVC coupling pressed against each other, being held together with a bunch of hot glue. Now what we need to do is drill a hole to let the water drain from one bottle into the other. To drill the hole, I'm using a 3/8 inch drill bit. All right, we now have our tornado tube connector device. That should be working, so let's attach it to both bottles and see if we can get that nice vortex we were looking at. Stand it up straight. There we go. We have our tornado in a bottle. Or I guess it's in water, not air, so that's a maelstrom, not a tornado. There you go, how to build a working tornado tube connector in just a few minutes with some very basic parts. There are a couple things I want to try to make this look just a little bit cooler though. As the water is spinning down from one bottle into the other, you can see the vortex in the center, and that looks really cool. But I want to try something that lets you really see the water swirling around itself, so I'm going to add just a little bit of glitter to our water and see what that does. All right, I'm going to try and pour some glitter into our bottle without it getting everywhere, because I don't really want a glitter-covered workshop. All over my gloves already. It's spreading. The workshop is going to be glittery forever. All right, let's start by just shaking this up a little bit to get the glitter to mix into the water. There we go. Weirdly, still is floating quite a bit on the top. All right, I'm gonna try flipping it and swirling it around. There you go, there's your tornado. And you can definitely see it swirling around a lot more. Glitter does do a good job of catching the light. I guess that's kind of the whole point of glitter. This is interesting, if you look down at the bottom, how much of the glitter doesn't want to mix into the water and just sort of stays on the surface. All right, let's try that again. As soon as the vortex forms, for a second, all of the surface glitter gets pulled down into it and you have this really glittery vortex. And then it clears out and then you just have water with glitter in it swirling around and it settles in a layer there. wide vortex and just pulls the surface glitter down. It's like stuck to the sides of it now. That's really cool. That's funny. It's not dropping. It's like on the water side of the vortex, not the bubble side of the vortex. So some of it's just stuck there. That's an interesting effect. All right, that works pretty cool. Let's move on to our next filler. All right, we've emptied out most of the glitter, and now we're going to try filling one of our bottles about 2/3 full of tonic water. Tonic water is a sweetened beverage that contains quinine, and we'll see the advantage of something with quinine in just a second. All right, we've got our tonic water. There's our connector. Still a little bit of glitter on the inside of our cap, so that's already ending up in our tonic water, but that's all right. There we go. The bubbles are doing a fairly nice job, similar to the glitter that lets you see it spinning around, but that's not the real advantage of using tonic water. Now, the reason we're trying using tonic water is that quinine glows in a black light. So I have here a little black light. Check this out. Just lights it up. Bright blue. Kind of cool. You can see the path that the light is taking through the bottle. All right, and I also happen to have a larger black light here. Wow, you can already see how much that's lighting it up. So let's get this tornado going, and then I'll put the large black light up against it, and we'll have this just glowing blue tornado. Here goes. Ha! Look at that. Beautiful glowing maelstrom. It looks like we found some liquid from the movie Avatar and put it in a bottle. There we go. We filled it with quinine and put a black light next to it and got a really cool blue glowing effect. Now I've filled the bottle back up with regular water, and I'm going to be adding some glow-in-the-dark craft paint. This is an acrylic-based paint which should dilute nicely into the water when I shake it up. So I'm going to pour this in, and I'm going to see if we can get this to glow in the dark. Glowy paint, glowy paint. That looks like a good amount. That looks pretty well mixed. Let's give it just a little bit more to make sure. I'm going to try and squeeze the foam out and pour that off into the sink. I don't want bubbles. That worked great. All right, just a quick test. I'm gonna be using a black light to see the result. Black light is really good at charging glow-in-the-dark stuff very quickly. Oh, beautiful, look at that. Let's get some swirling action and then just, ha! That looks really cool. Just lights up and makes individual tiny, tiny little paint particles glow, and those get caught up in the swirl of the water. And they're so small, they don't hold much of a glowing charge for long, but it's still pretty cool. All right, let's try getting a whole whirlpool here. Now, of course, the paint has made the liquid a bit more opaque, so you can't really see the whirlpool itself. But now when we light up part of it with our black light, it starts swirling around really cool. When I hold it right here, you can watch the glowing paint run down the side of the bottle and mix with the rest of the paint. Let's try it with the big black light, see what happens. Get some charge, see if we can get all of it glowing before we start our tornado. This black light is about a million times more powerful. All right, let's flip this. Keep. That looks pretty cool. Just glowing up here, runs down. It's not glowing too much on the sidewalls. That I can make it glow more on the sides. That looks so cool as it drips down into the bottle. It's just like liquid light pouring down. There you go, how to build your very own vortex funnel device for just a couple of dollars, and it only takes a few minutes. I hope you've also liked the look of the glitter, the tonic water, and the glow-in-the-dark paint to give your swirling vortex a couple of different looks. Thanks guys for joining us for this project today, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.
Extra fine, meaning it gets everywhere even more and is even harder to get rid of.
Yay!
Oh, I was doing so well. Couple of drops spilled, nothing too bad.
Hey guys, thanks so much for caring about our content and our channel so much. It really is amazing to have great people like you jumping in to watch every new video that gets uploaded and watching it to the end. You really are amazing, and we appreciate you for that.